All right, ladies and gentlemen, we are back in the Pratt Pack Gym, and you know your Pratt Pack is a fierce competitor, as in Gatorade. Quench your thirst, get hydrated, stop in at one of your neighborhood Sheetz convenience stores. I'm always there, and there's one in your neighborhood. All right, you may see me in your neighborhood this week. Why? Because I'm going to be all over the place through Thursday. Coming up later tonight, Cassidy Emanuel. We'll talk to Mayor Ryan Stovall and Ted Arnault talking the top 10 of the NFL's top 100 for 2017. And some Steelers news as well. He'll join us on the Comcast Sports Line. That's later tonight. Now, tomorrow night, it's going to be the club at Shadow Lakes. Elwood Willard, their manager of the grounds, and I are going to take you out on the course and show you some incredible new development. That's right, new development that you're going to want to check out as far as what he has done with his magic touch at that incredible place that is a public golf course, the club at Shadow Lakes. And then my buddy Mark Miner and I are going to be together with a living legend in Beaver County. Maybe one of the smartest people I have ever met when it comes to economic development. For many years, the man behind Michael Baker, Dick Shaw. Mark and I are going to be at the Beaver train station for some amazing videos you do not want to miss. And just like E.F. Hutton, when Dick Shaw talks, everyone listens, including me. So looking forward to talking to the legendary Dick Shaw, who's been a friend of your Pratt Pack for decades. It's going to be a great night, Thursday night, at the Beaver train station. Now, let me just talk a little politics, okay? Affordable Care Act, climate change, Cuba, Iran, those are some of the big things that then-President Barack Obama accomplished during his presidency. And yes, he did stop in at Crutchmeyer's Bakery to see Lincoln and Company when he was in town many years ago, and that's something we'll always be grateful for in this region. But President Donald Trump has been fighting battles on all fronts, and he continues to attack the former president. But President Barack Obama kind of staying the course and saying, look, I'm done. I don't think it's the place of a former president to be up on that political stage. So he is going to just stand on the radar and continue with a low profile. But that's going to be very interesting to look at as that 1-2 punch, that counterpunch back and forth continues between our current president and former President Barack Obama. Now, the health care bill. We talked about it in length last night on Rob Pratt Monday night. Thank you for all your amazing phone calls. We had Dr. Terry Madonna drop by. He had some amazing thoughts on it politically. And I must tell you, today, right now as we speak, a power lunch underway with Majority Leader Mitch McConnell and Vice President Michael Pence. They are seeing what they can do to go forward. And, well, one of the aides for the GOP told CNN yesterday, when asked about where they are right now, about the health care bill, he said, hanging by a thread. Now, what else is going on? Here's something that I have been a big proponent of for a long time, as has my friend Ted Arnault. It's legalized sports book betting. You know what they do in Las Vegas. So far, you can't do it anywhere other than Las Vegas and in London, right? Well, the Supreme Court today says they're going to hear arguments about why New Jersey wants to have it. Governor Chris Christie has been doing a great job fighting this law. And he believes, as I do, this is my opinion now, it'll be a great economic stimulus for that wonderful Garden State, New Jersey, and also help Atlantic City, who could use a little help right now. And the thing you got to remember, folks, there are thousands upon thousands of people directly or not connected directly, but still there's that paycheck that comes from the world of gaming. And that's why I'm such a big fan of it. And if we are fortunate enough to have a little extra time tonight with Mr. Arnault, I'll talk about this developing story with him, but that's one I'm definitely going to have a very close eye on. All right, let's kind of move into what else is happening. Weather-wise, AccuWeather, nice day, sun is out, and it's a beautiful June day. You know, June is winding down, folks, and before you know it, 4th of July coming up on Tuesday, and your Pratt Pack is going to be a very busy man right through the 4th of July, but especially the next three nights. I hope you will definitely follow me here on Facebook or YouTube because we're going to have some amazing video for you, some stuff that we've never done before. And one of them I'm really looking forward to is my conversation with Dick Shaw, because if you think about this Shell petrochemical plant, Mr. Shaw for many years with Michael Baker, during his time there, and Mr. Baker, a lot of people don't realize, they were a significant part of Saudi Arabia when they were laying the petro, meaning gas lines for oil, right? And he believes, in a conversation that I had with him many years ago, what he is seeing with the natural gas industry, it is very similar to what was happening in the petroleum oil or gas that you put in your automobile and we use to power the world, as they were the big architect behind that in Saudi Arabia many years ago, says he sees a lot of similarities, and especially with what's happening with this footprint, this huge footprint right here in our area. And that, of course, the Royal Dutch Shell Company's multi-billion dollar investment at that petrochemical plant. And I must tell you, I'm watching it unfold every day, and I get more and more excited every day. And to have Mr. Shaw connecting the dots, it is going to be some kind of interview on Thursday night at the Beaver train station. So I hope that you will definitely be around for that one. Now, sports news. By the way, I was telling you about, you know, the greatest of all time, those top 100. Well, no surprise, Tom Brady is number one, and rightfully so. And I don't think there is an argument that he is the greatest quarterback ever to play in the NFL. Speaking of greatest of all time, 23 Grand Slam titles. She's my favorite. Serena Williams, wishing her the best as she is about ready in a few short weeks to give birth to her very first child. She's kind of away from tennis right now, but you know what? John McEnroe, who was always fun to watch, he's a great analyst. He's got a new book out. A lot of people are talking about. He was on NPR, and he made a comment about how she wouldn't be any better than maybe ranked 700. All she did, in a very stylish way, Serena Williams sent out this tweet. Dear John, I adore you, but please, please keep me out of your statement that are not factually based. So Serena Williams, a little touche, if you will, with John McEnroe. Bucks back at PNC Park tonight. Great night to get to the ballpark. Tampa Bay, it will be Alex Cobb taking on, of course, the Pirates, and Trevor Williams gets the start for the Buccos. They're five back, and that game a little after 7 on 93.7 The Fan. Going to be a great week at the ballpark. Tampa Bay and then San Francisco. 1-800-BUY-BUCKS. All right, folks, that's enough. I'll see you later tonight. Cassidy Emanuel, Mayor Ryan Stovall, and Ted Arnault on the NFL. Should be a great time. And remember, it's always the best food. Old Italian cuisine. Yes, made from scratch. Meatballs and sauce. Oh, can't take it. It's so good. Have a great day, everybody. Time to go to work in the Pratt Pat Gym. Tonight, Cassidy Emanuel. See you then.